Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host Jason Turner. In this episode, I want to discuss how we might be able to make a better main. Now, let's clarify, I am by far not the first person to go down this road, but I think there's some fun ideas to play with, so be sure you stick around. Now, of course, I do have to remind you that I am available for code reviews and on-site training, and I would be happy to discuss either of those options with you. You should be able to find my contact information in the video description, as well as links to things like t-shirts and books and my puzzle books and all the fun things that help support this channel. A lot of people like the idea of having a main that looks kind of like this. And well, there's problems with this, and the main problem being that it's very difficult to do something like change the signature of main, and it's not something that the standards committee has really seriously considered as far as I know. So let's just talk about maybe how you could do your own version kind of like this. Now, I can't actually declare main like this because I'm going to get all kinds of errors from the compiler saying that this is not a valid signature for main. Main is a special function. So let's just go ahead and call this a better main. Let's just go ahead and mark this maybe unused for the moment. But this gives us a nice, clean, friendly, type-safe way of looking at the arguments passed to our function main, and also, interestingly, forces us to return a value from main if we have any kind of warnings enabled whatsoever here, where the regular main isn't able to enforce that because by default it returns zero. So I started wondering how to actually make this a thing. And after having gone through several different iterations, plus looked at options from viewers, you should, of course, as always, check out the description of this video for a link to the GitHub issue where we discuss this particular topic. This is a version that I came up with. Now, you should probably watch my episode on the most vexing parse to see why this code even really compiles. It is that I am forward declaring a function inside of my main. So I don't have to pollute the rest of the namespace in any way. No one else gets to know that I'm expecting a thing called better main. I'm just going ahead and forward declaring it here. And now I need to call this, but I need some sort of collection of string views. This isn't something that I can just create on the stack in an easy way because I need something that can actually hold the span. And I don't want to push that to better main. I don't want it to have to be a vector or, you know, whatever. And we want to kind of maintain this contiguousness of the container. So I came up with an idea that looks like this. Now, just in a way for the fun of it, I want to point out that you actually can change argv in some situations, but it's generally considered bad code to do that because you don't know where those strings point to. So for safety here, we're going to just be clear about the fact that argv is a const pointer to a const pointer to a const character. And we may as well go ahead and make argc const. And it is incredibly ironic that argc is an integer because nothing else that is a size type in the C or C++ world is an int. Everything else is an unsigned int. All the indexes into arrays and such are. So that's something else that we'll need to deal with. But we have marked all these things const and made them as const as possible. So I'm going to initialize this. And I'm going to initialize it safely. by taking argv as the first, and then I'm going to use the next helper that takes an iterator and increments it by a certain amount, which is pointer arithmetic in this case. The compiler will take care of that for us, which is argc here. Now this is going to compile, but depending on your compiler settings, it really shouldn't, because argc is an int, and we actually need a pointer to t here. So let's just be pedantically correct, which, as we know, is the best kind of correct. And now we can call better main with our args, which will be implicitly converted to a span. And there's a conversation to have about that, but the standard library has that conversion. So I guess we'll go ahead and take advantage of it at the moment. And note now I'm getting a compile time error because I did not deal with the no discard result of better main. So this is interesting. So the program actually works, and with this forward declared better main, it is expecting a better main to exist somewhere. If I were to comment this out, then I will actually get a link time error that it was unable to find this better main to actually call and find reference. Here we go. So this has an interesting side effect. If we were to look at the code this way, then we could declare our better main const expr, which would require us to forward declare it as const expr. Do we require our better main to be const expr? Maybe not, but if we could, then it would give us a little bit more opportunity for testing the entire system at compile time. There's no way for us to require it to be no discard, but it is considered an error by clang tidy to have main that might throw an exception, because that's going to just be caught by the runtime. So we could enforce no except here so that the person writing better main knows that they need to deal with any exceptions that they want to deal with inside of this, and to be incredibly clear that if any exception escapes from a better main, then it will in fact call terminate. So yeah, there you go. I don't know if this should be considered good code or not. I think it's interesting code. The main thing that I don't like about it is that it does require this heap allocation of the vector of elements of type string view. And we could kind of get around that by using a PMR vector, which would definitely be interesting. And we could just create a local stack of elements. But it would probably make more sense if we really wanted to go down that road of just creating an array. But in either case, if we want to avoid the heap allocation, then we have to tell the compiler the maximum number of arguments that we're going to support. 255 arguments to your program? Perhaps that's enough. I'm not sure. In initializing, it becomes slightly more complicated. Now, even though this version works, I find it somehow slightly less satisfying. We have to be a little bit more careful about the size. We limit the number of args to 255, maybe that's irrelevant. We have to do a little bit more casting to make sure we've got proper matches for the types that are expected for these function calls. We have to manually construct our string view. I think there might be a cleaner way of doing that. Actually, there might be a cleaner way of doing that, but we're still going to leave it how it is because of an implicit conversion. So it works. And it's simpler in some ways and less satisfying in other ways, but our actual main is relatively simple here. I don't know. It's some interesting ideas to play with. Like I said, check out the video description to see all the different options that were proposed and some links to some of them. But I will say it is so much better to work with the args passed to your main like this than it is any other way. And I actually use a version of this in most programs that I write today. This is what the average main function I write today looks like. I don't use this dispatching to better main thing, but I do in fact create a vector of string views of the arguments first thing inside of main, so that then I can just operate on them and I don't have to do any weird pointer arithmetic or anything. Anyhow, again, I hope you liked this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe.